In this video, what I want to show you is how we can take the bevels that we previously developed geometrically and transfer them onto a steel square or a roofing square so that we actually use them on the job site. So let's start with the two most common ones, the plumb and level bevel for our common rafter, which are those two there. So obviously you can see that they're made up of a triangle, which consists of our half span and the rise. So we need to know what dimensions they are. So in this case, our half span is going to be a meter, and our rise per meter for this roof, which is 30 degrees, is going to be 577 millimeters. And obviously if you're going to do a different pitch, that dimension would change. The half span doesn't have to, but the rise will. So let's go and have a look at our steel square. So our steel square is 600 millimeters long on what we call the blade, and 400 millimeters long on the tongue. So what we need to try and do is make sure we put the longest dimension onto the blade all the time. So our half span is a meter. Obviously that's not going to fit, so we can divide that by 2. That'll give us 500, that'll fit. We can put a button or our fence on that mark. With our rise, we had a rise of 577, and we obviously, of course, we've divided this side by 2, we need to divide this side by 2, so that gives us 288, and once again we put a button or a fence on there, and that will form our angle to give us our plumb and level bevels for our common rafters. So that's the first two done. Number 3, which is our edge bevel for our common rafter, or creeper, is this bevel up here. Okay, and it's formed using a triangle which has the true length of the common rafter, which we'd have to calculate, and we can use Pythagoras to work out what that length is. We can just use the half span and the rise, do the Pythagoras, and we can get the true length of the common rafter, which in this case happens to be 1 meter 155. A half span, which we know already is a meter, that'll give us our edge bevel creeper, and by default our edge bevel purlin. So we jump back over to the steel square. So our longest dimension was 1 meter 155, so it's got to go on the blade. We could divide that by 2 and the answer would fit. However, if we go up this side, our half span is a meter. That divided by 2, this is going to be 500. Obviously, this is only 400 long, so it's not going to fit. So we have to divide this side by 3 to fit on. So that divided by 3 is 333. This one divided by 3, 385. Put your button or fence into place, and that way we'll form the edge bevel creeper and the edge bevel purlin. Make sure you take note of which side of the actual square the angle's formed. Okay, so if we go back and have a look at our little geometric development, number 3 was formed with the true length common rafter and the hypotenuse of the triangle. So when we go back to the square, we need true length common rafter and the hypotenuse. That'll give us where that angle is. So that's our edge bevel creeper down here. Okay, and edge bevel purlin on the other side. Okay, so that's all our common rafter creeper angles, or bevels, so now we need to do some for the hip. So our hip, plumb and level bevel hip, they're made up of our rise, or a triangle containing the rise, and the plan length of the hip. Okay, so our rise is still 577. The plan length of our hip, because this is a meter, and that's a meter, obviously this dimension here is commonly known and can be easily calculated using Pythagoras, is 1 meter 414. So this dimension here, 1 meter 414. So take that over to our steel square. So once again, rise on this side, our plan length hip on this side, 1 meter 414, divide it so it fits onto the square. In this case, we have to divide this side by 3 to give us 471. So we divide this side by 3, gives us 192. Buttons into place, and we get our plumb and level bevel for our hip. So then we need to know our edge bevel for our hip. And our edge bevel is created using the true length of the hip, which once again can be calculated using Pythagoras at the rise and the planned length of the hip. That'll give you true length. And we need this line up here, which is the planned length of the hip. So we need true length, planned length, and the angle is next to the true length. So we go to the steel square. True length works out to be 1 meter 527. So obviously it's the longest of the dimensions, and we have to divide that by 4 to get it to fit onto the steel square. It gives us 382, so we put our button on there. Our plan length is 1414. Divide that by 4, gives us 354. Button on there. That'll form the angle. And the bevel that we need, the edge bevel for the hip, is just here on this side, the true length of the hip side, or on the blade side of the square. And the last bevel we need, which is our face bevel for our purlin, it's created using a triangle which contains the true length of the common rafter, which we've worked out previously, which is 1 meter 155, and our rise, which we know is 577, and the angle is up there near the rise and the hypotenuse, the bevel that we need. So again, we can jump back to our steel square. Rise on this side, true length common rafter on this side. So in this case, true length common rafter divided by 2, this is 577, so that fits 578 there. 577 divided by 2 gives us 288, so that'll fit on that side. And that creates our face bevel purlin with the bevel being up near the rise on that side of the actual square. So there we go. We've taken our 8 bevels that we developed geometrically, and with a little bit of calculation, we've been able to transfer them onto our steel square so we can actually use them and transfer them onto the roof.